Good evening to everyone. So, welcome to our midweek Bible study. And it seems like I'm so excited. My the tone of voice is there. Anyway, let's start with our praise and thanksgiving for God. Has somebody like to say anything about what has transpired in his life or her life just for this weekend, for any day, just to give some praise to God? Anybody can start. All right, let me start. So I'd like to thank God for what am I thanking God? Anyway, I thank God for I was able to settle my income tax now. Instead of paying, we were able to find a solution not to pay that much. And at the same time, God made provisions for it. So I thank God for that. If not, I'll be in a hole for something. But, you know, God filled that hole. Hindi niya pinabayaang ma-ano sabit. So that's my praise and thanksgiving to God. It's very short, but it's something that I want to share. Because sometimes people have the same predicament, and you know, it's an encouraging thing that we sometimes we don't even know that it can encourage people. So that's my take. And anybody wants to say anything?
You can go, Papa.
No, si Mama mo daw. Nag-open lang ako ng computer. And ng audio.
Well, I really praise God. I was able to, I'm able to attend the Bible study tonight. Last week was really a hectic schedule at work. So it's like, so tiring. But thank God for the strength. And God is good. Kasi yeah. It's like we're still understaffed. So we get stuff from registry. So, but later, an hour later, they will not, I mean, during the shift, they will not show up, you know? And I work 12-hour shift now because it's a subacute. So it's like last week, it's like aside from, I work 6 days last week, 12-hour shift. So it's really hard. It's so tiring. But I thank God. This week, I feel rested. Thank God I'm here. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Ako naman, I just want to thank God for being me with my wife. Kasi for 6 days, 6 nights, she was not with me. Anyway, so I thank God for the strength and for always protecting me. And like what I mentioned before, I shared before, traveling is an issue. Going back home, it's because of, you know, tiredness, sleepiness and everything. But I thank God for the covering protection this morning, this evening also going back home. And I want to thank the Lord for the first Wednesday for our church for fasting, and I really thank God for that. So I did remember, and it was in my mind. So thank God for allowing the whole body of church to connect and to really fast for our San Francisco as well. Amen.
Amen. Amen. So yeah, this is the first day of our fasting, at community fasting for the whole church, and this is the first time, or not this first time, but this is really the first time that I joined in fasting in a way. And it's like, as I told Pastor before, last time we spoke, is I don't eat breakfast and lunch. So it's my dinner. That's where I fill my tummy with all the food that I need. But today is like really a struggle because I don't have breakfast, I don't have lunch, but then dinner is like, my tummy is calling for it. So what I did is just concentrate on like praise and worship, just listen to the praise and worship and read, as Pastor said, change your ways. So it helped me a bit. It helped me because I just had some hot chocolate, so just to calm my stomach down. But it's good. I think it will be best for everybody, for all of us as well, for individually and corporately. So it's the first day. And anybody else?
Yeah, I want to share. Also, I got a testimony because the Lord has really healed me. I did the blood test and everything, and they said I have no problem with the blood test. And I did the ultrasound about Friday, and they're supposed to call me if something is, you know, issue or going on. And they haven't called me or anything, so that means, you know, everything is good and great. So I was really thankful to God because I was scared when, you know, when the doctor said that I have a prostate infection and, I'm expecting something is going to show up, but, you know, God is a God of miracle. And, you know, it's whatever is there, he just took it away. And I'm thankful for that because, you know, God is really a healer. And I'm also thankful because today is our togetherness anniversary when Mara said, you know, yes. And I always tell her on our anniversary that I always remember when she told me yes, I can only afford Taco Bell. That's that's our date. And I got her from Taco Bell. As soon as she ate the Taco Bell, she said yes. I was really thankful. We always tell that story to our kids. You know, how did I get your mom? You know, we're like, our first date is Taco Bell. Oh, that's why you guys like Taco Bell. That's what the kids are on. But it's really a wonderful experience, you know, with the walk with my wife and the kids and with our walk with God. So I'm really thankful for that.
Amen for Taco Bell too.
So did you get Taco Bell today?
That's why she's not smiling. There's no Taco Bell.
Fasting tayo, di ba?
I know, huh? Taco Bell goes a long way, Kutin. So anybody else? All right, can we do praise and worship before we start?
And all my life.
Father, we thank you and we honor you for tonight. We thank you so much that we can come together, study what we have learned from Sunday's preaching, that we be put into remembrance, Lord, your faithfulness. Lord, we love you so much, Lord God, because, Lord, your goodness ran after us. Your faithfulness is always there, Lord God, even through the darkest times. And all we can say is, Lord, we love you so much. There's no other words, Lord God, that we can really say. Our vocabulary is finite, Lord God. But you know, Lord God, that our heart is pure for you, Lord God. Our hearts desire is just to long, is to understand, to love you, Lord God, wholeheartedly. And we invite you, Holy Spirit, to be in our midst. You said when two or three are gathered in your name, you'll be there. And we believe that you are with us. Continue, Lord, to anoint each and every one. Continue, Lord, to give a revelation to each and every one as a church and as an individual. That whatever we learn, Lord God, can be a help to others, Lord God. Because, Lord, your revelation is always different from each and every one of us. So we thank you, God. We thank you, Holy Spirit, for your presence. We thank you for what you're going to do tonight. Because, you know, there'll be something good will come out of this Bible study. We love you, Lord, and we always wish you, Lord God, wholehearted love from us because you love us first. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
I don't know, Sister Percy want to say something because she unmuted a while ago for the worship, I guess. they celebrated their anniversary yesterday. So,
Sister First,
you're muted.
Okay, no, I'm just gonna say thank God for for fasting, because today I didn't cook, so the whole family fasted. At least now I have one day free from cooking. But I was so surprised when Bert told me that, you know, even the kids nag-fasting din sila. So that's good. I'm not sure if Luna fasted too. Amen. And I just want to thank God also for our anniversary for another year. And truly, it was a wonderful celebration that we did yesterday. We go out and eat, and truly a blessing is in there. It was a blessing. I'm ready to pay that much, but I didn't pay that much because God blessed us with it. Thank you, Patricia.
Amen.
So, and then also after the dinner, we go to the San Pedro and we're able to serve. And, you know, but a memorable celebration on our 35th anniversary. Amen.
Amen. Congratulations again, Sister. And you owe us a dinner. Anyway, so... let's start, because we just want to go back to what the teaching was. Pastor talked about the power of remembrance, which is also the book about Deuteronomy 8. It's about book of remembrance. She said the power of remembrance allows us to see the power of faithfulness. Remembering the day when we got saved is the start of our wilderness. Not 40 years, but it's a start of our wilderness. Every journey have a destination, and our destination is about our triumph, our victory, and God's will indwelling in us. Remember the day when we accepted God, accepted our Savior, and that day changed our lives. Pastor was like very specific with her. Being saved, I'm not one of those that really have a pinpoint on when I was saved. I know a different story. I don't know if I was saved that day, but it was just like it was with Sister Angie. I don't know if you know her. It was Sister Angie's house. I know Reggie was saved that day on that Bible study, because I was not in the Bible study. I was down with the husband having some sort of cocktail. So I don't believe that was the day I got saved. Probably the next day, but no, I know gradually I got see the changes that my wife is going through. That's where I really focus on get interested in how she got changed. So there's no specific time for me, but I know it was, I got changed. That's all I need to know, that God changed my life. God changed the perspective of how I look at life, you know, because that's a day that you will change, your life will be changed. Everything will change, your attitude, your character, because once you have Jesus, you know, it's a different outlook already. When you first got saved, you remember like how Jesus was so, like, he's so close to you, like he is there always. Answered prayers is like left and right. Like your hunger for him is there. And then as you grow older in faith, you tend to slow down. You tend to be complacent about it. You get to, you know, really like, oh, I'm saved already. Right? But you have to work on that salvation, as we've talked about. But remembering our victory, our failures, but most of all, God's goodness during those like honeymoon times, as we call it, as girlfriend and boyfriend, and then we got married. Those are the first few years that we are really excited to see one another, really spending time together, But then as we get older, I'm not saying I'm losing interest with my wife. She's still there. No, it's just like sometimes you just get so familiar with which started, then you just like really slow down. And it is so hard to accept it sometimes, but it happens to me. You know, I just like slow down here and there and then go back again, slow down here and there. I remember Sister Myra said, "Welcome back." Because I keep like popping in, popping out, popping in, popping out. It's not consistent. And that's not how I should be as a child of God. Because, you know, thank you for that reminder. As I said, I didn't leave. I'm just like watching. Anyway, so we remember the past. Pastor said, remember the past. Help us to be prepared for the future. It also helps us to see where we are headed. And it also prepares us for the triumph to see and be grateful because we relied faithfully in Christ. We remember so we won't forget our purpose of obedience and praise to God. We should always be obedient in all His command, but obedience sometimes is difficult, as Pastor said too. Obedience to God is always a struggle because our human desire resists to obey God, which is very true. Obedience takes really a lot of effort on your side, especially when it comes to following Jesus. There's a lot of things that you have to remove in your way of life. Your garbage, your baggage will have to be moved. And, you know, like the story in the Bible, the rich man, he was doing good, he was doing everything. But then when God asked him to sell everything, that's a baggage that he wasn't able to do. And he left. He left because he cannot sell he cannot get rid of all the wealth that he has. He wants to obey God, but that's hard for him. It cost us difficulty, but the goodness of God will propel us to obey, and our command is just to obey. Remembering is just like a memorial or a marker to remind us of what happened. Like example was Joshua. He piled up rocks by the edge of the Jordan River to remind them of the miracle in crossing to the promised land. We are like, another example is like in our time, when you see flowers on the road, it's a memorial to somebody who died. It's a remembrance. So remembering is very good because we don't forget what had happened, good or bad. It is in our memory bank already. So that's what Joshua did. So they will know that God did a miracle for them. They were able to cross the Jordan River to go to the promised land. God is good at opening ways when there's no way, just like what he did with the Israelites. They were led from captivity to freedom from slavery, from cruelty under Pharaoh, evils of the Antichrist, just to name a few of them. God opened a way or provided a way. There is always a way for God. For man, it's impossible, but for God, it's possible. There's nothing impossible with God. God opened a way or provided a way. What did he do? He parted the Red Sea so they can cross. He led them out of the wilderness. He changed the bitter water to a drinkable one. And also he provided food, which is the manna. And for us in this generation, we also are captives before we know Jesus. We are in our own wilderness. We are slaves of the world. We are slaves of darkness. We are slaves of evil, of human desire. And when we accepted God as our Lord and Savior, He broke that bandage. He broke that chain. He freed us. He remembers each and every prayer that we do. And He will answer that in His perfect time. He's never late. He's always on time. We should always also remember that testing is not being punished, but we are being transformed to be strong in faith. It results in less dependency of yourself and more from God. And our faith grows as we see more of God's faithfulness. Testing is like the gold that Pastor was talking about. That's the example that she gave, is the refining of the gold. That before it could get pure, it could be the 99.9% gold. It has to go to extreme heat. Just like us, to be refined, we go through trials. What's good with us is we have God to persevere for us, to help us, to see the victory at the end of the tunnel, at the destination that He's showing us with our journey. So I've said destination is triumph. No, I'm just giving them a few things. All impurities in our life get burned by trials, as stated in 1 Peter 6 and 7. So that is just an insight of what I got from the teaching last Sunday, and that there's more. And I will open the floor to each and everyone so you can give your take to the... Angela, is it you who can put the four questions? So the first question was, what was the primary command of God to the Israelites in Deuteronomy 8? Second, what was the secondary command? And why and for what purpose? And then, what is the purpose of testing? Why is it? And why do we need to remember? So, I open the floor. I know you're excited because you have a history with God. You want to share what happened with that journey. And whatever you want to answer, whichever number you want to answer, just go ahead. So I open the floor to you guys now. So excited. I know you're excited. Nobody wants to speak. I leave it to you guys. What was the first question? Why? What was the command, right? What was God's command? The primary command of God. This is what I wrote. This is what I wrote for me. It says dear, be careful. The primary command was, I don't know if it's right, is follow every command I'm giving you today. Follow every command. So I'm not sure if that is the right answer because I got it from Deuteronomy. Follow all the commands. Follow. And then, I don't know, I might be wrong. I just want to hear your input on that. On you're what correct. Was primary.
I think, brother, you're correct. To me, you are correct.
Okay.
I'll continue. Your answer is correct. That is my answer too, because that is the first one that the word of God in Deuteronomy 8 says. I just want to read, as you said, it says, every command which I command you today, you must be careful to observe. You said follow, observe, it's just the same, you know. And you may live and multiply and go in and possess the land which the Lord swore to your fathers. So to me, that is the first command that God wants his people to do. Because if you go back to the different to the other from 6-7, these are all the commands that he told, you know, Moses, when they were ready to cross, you know, the promised land. And then he gave all these commandments, especially in chapter 7, verses 12 up to the end, 26. These are all the blessings of obedience. It all mentioned in here, in chapter 7, before chapter 8. That's why in chapter 8, he says every command. What is that command? It goes back to chapter 7. That's why it says every command which I command you today, you must be careful to observe. See, he wants the people to obey. As you said, to do, to observe, or to obey all the commandments that he gave them in the previous chapter 7. I think it started in 6. So I think that is the first commandment that God wants every the Israelites on that day, you know, that they must be careful to observe, that they must obey all of the commandments that God has given them. God wants a total obedience. Mm-hmm. He said all, you know. So which means to say they have to obey all what he mentioned in chapter 6 and 7. Okay. And if they will obey, what will be the result? You know, that they will have good life in the land. What is the land? The land that he promised them. And that is the promised land. That's why, to me, as you said, the first command is that they observe, that they obey all the commandments, all. It is a total obedience, complete obedience. Not only some of the commandment, but I think it says all, complete, you know, so that they will have a good life, a blessed life, to going to the promised land where God has, that is where God promised them that they're going to go to the promised land. And as we go on, and that is the first one, and the second one is another command. And okay, I just stop there in the first command because maybe somebody wants to say something too.
Yeah, that's what I got to is this, you know, follow every command. Yeah. It's NIV. And mm-hmm. Remember, when you follow God, there's always a blessing attached to it.
Yeah.
Right? So it says it, if follow my God, I'm giving you today, so that you may live and increase and may enter and possess the land the Lord promised to the ancestors.
Live and multiply.
Yeah, I think I anybody can chime in. So for me and for Mrs. Serno, I think that is the first command because I'm that's why maybe we have hesitation. We're not sure.
Okay. So for me, this is what I got. Okay. Because the question is focusing on Deuteronomy 8. If we're going to take a look at New King James Version, it says here, verse 1, every commandment which I commanded you today, you must be careful to observe that. First command, you may live and multiply.
Mm-hmm.
Second command, go in and possess the land of which the Lord swore to your fathers. So for me, those are the commandments I got focusing on Deuteronomy 8. And you may live and multiply because God knows exactly that these people will face trials and everything. Amidst those trials and persecution and whatever hindrance says, you know, to go to the promised land, then they are commanded to multiply, right? Now, so that is the first command. The second one is to go in and possess the land which the Lord swore to your fathers. That's why, Pastora, the message of the Lord last Sunday, amidst the trials, but still the Lord blessed them, right? So they were able to go to the promised land. And because that is the promise of the Lord, that is the covenant of the Lord, right? That's why they're able to get to the promised land. So for me, those are the things I got, okay? Focusing on Deuteronomy 8 only.
Anybody else?
Okay, I'll add to my, maybe others can give there before I give mine again. Because number one and two, it is a continuation, like Brother Ted was saying, you know, to him, that was the first and second command. But to me, as I base my answer to the scriptures, it says the first command is obedience. And then the second command is you have to remember, remembrance. You know, to me, the second one is remembering what the Lord had done. You know, I just want to read 1 and 2. Every command which I command you today, you must be careful to observe, that you may live and multiply and go and possess the land in which the Lord swore to your fathers. That to me is the first command. And the second one is, and you shall remember. That is to me the second command. You have to remember that the Lord your God led you all the way these 40 years in the wilderness to humble you and to test you, to know that what was in your heart, whether you would keep his commandments or not. To me, this is the first and the second command. You know, it continues. The first is observe, or you have to do complete obedience. Yeah. And the outcome is that of that, if you obey, you know, you will multiply. You will live and multiply, and you will possess the promised land that God has promised them. And the second one is verse 2. And you shall remember, that is the second command. To me, that is how I understand this one. That's why you have to remember. This is now the remembrance that we are talking about, you know. And I think this is where Pastor, you know, concentrated on this remembrance, you know, what God wants them to do first, obey, obedience, and then remember. And then we will go on to the what do they have to remember, you know.
Yeah.
That's what I got, Brother John.
Yeah, yun din ang ano ko kasi nga, yun sa version ni Brother sa New King James is different. It sounds different from sa version ng NIV. Kasi sa NIV, NIV says, so that you may live and increase and may enter. So that you may live and increase. Yeah. That is yun ang keyword sa akin, that may live and increase.
Yeah, that it's is not, the that outcome is, of your
obedience. Yeah, yun ang blessing ng binigay niya kung obedient kayo eh.
Yeah.
So yun lang ang ano ko. Tapos sabi niya, in remembrance, that you and you should humble yourself and test yourself. Yun ang inaano niya. Yun ang second ko. So I don't know. input, please.
I have the same answer with Sister Nona. I read the NLT version. And in NLT version, it says, be careful to obey all the commandments I am giving you. So it's like obey his commands, keep his commandments, and then you will live and multiply. So living and multiply will follow if you obey his commands. So you know, first, and then second answer is remember the Lord your God din po in God led us through the wilderness for these 40 years. So if we will remember, just remember his goodness. So everything will follow. Also, yung protection is there. Yung provision is there. The Lord never did not fail us. So yun lang po.
Anybody else?
Just to add up, because like what Sister Nona mentioned, it's the remembrance, right? So if we're going to take a look at verse 18, Deuteronomy 8, it says there, you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth, that he may confirm his covenant that he swore to your fathers as it is this day. So I think since Pastora also talked about remembrance, so yes, that's one of the commandments, remembering the Lord. And I just want to segue with remembrance with regards to my salvation. Because like what we have heard from the message last Sunday, that is where you gonna grow also your faith. And I remember when I got saved, that was in Jeddah, Saudi Arabia. It coincides with the topic for today, because 3 days ago, I received a message from the pastor in Jeddah, where I received the Lord Jesus Christ. And then he was saying like, it's our 16th anniversary JIL. So we want you to give us your greetings as husband and wife. And yesterday we did it. So when he texted me, I remembered the time that I was saved, and I was able to, I mean, my wife introduced me to Jesus Christ. So that's the power of remembrance, because you are looking back what happened during that day and how that day started your journey with God and how the change happened from that. So that's why remembering really is important for us to see the goodness of God from the time I was in darkness and then taken out from there and then saw the light. So that's the power of remembrance for me. Amen.
Amen.
Idagdag lang sa good news translation para mas ano, kasi parang dito mas malinaw siya. Sabi, obey faithfully all the laws that I have given you today. So I'm blessing so that you may live increasing number and occupy the land that the Lord promised to your ancestor. The second niya is command niya is to remember nga, you know, how the Lord your God led you in this long journey through the desert this past 40 years. Amen. So yun ang you know, second nga yung kasi nag-focus si Pastor doon sa remembrance eh. Yung sa ano niya. So command niya is to remember, for us to remember, you know, what he did and what he is doing. You know, he is telling the Israelites, never forget what I did for you. Yung mga ito pinare-remember sa mga Israelites. And
yeah, he did.
Especially in the Old Testament, in the New Testament, yun ang ano niya, you do this, you know, this is my commandment, do this and this, this, these are the blessings that you will have. You know, at saka yung ano nga, especially the Israelites, you know, they always forget. Madali silang makalimot. And I think it's the same for us also. That's why he said, remember. This is my second commandment, remember how the Lord your God led you. Huwag mong kalilimutan ang ginawa ko sa inyo. So that, parati may blessing na kasunod sa mga commandments na ginagawa niya sa atin. So, you know, just like for Israelites, it's also the same for us. We have to remember what God did for me. Just like for me, I have to remember what God did for me. No, he died for me, for my salvation. And just like Pastor was saying, you know, you have to remember everything. Who you are before and who you are now. And even on good times and bad times, we have to remember. Because even especially on those bad times, he is always faithful and he is always there for us. He doesn't leave us. You know, so we have to remember, you know. So yun din ano ko, yung 1 and 2, you know, as for the commandments ng Panginoon sa Israelites. And it also goes for us today.
And, so you know, what's happening is like we are answering number 4 as we go number 1. So it's looking, it seems like it's paralleling itself.
Yeah.
kasi you have to justify the command, and it's about remembering. So that's a good thing too, that we are touching number four as well, and we're giving our take on it. So just continue whatever comes out, and then we can just tie it all together later on.
Amen.
We'll have things.
I'll say something. Okay, we know that we have the first command and the second command. So it's the obedience, and we have the blessings. And the second command says, remember. So why is this telling us the command to remember, right? So I was just reminded, see, we have a tendency, if we are engulfed in all these blessings, then we forget where it's coming from. That's right. Why we have that command, remember, for God. It's human nature. It's our nature. So it's the blessings, the so many blessings that we are not able to handle, that we forget where it's coming from. I was just reminded in one of my readings that this person, his prayer was, Lord, don't give me so much richness that my time for you will be diminished because of that richness. And we just talk about the revivalist, Wigglesworth, that he started being really poor, and then he went up and he had his own plumbing business, and they progressed, but that plumbing business resulted to him backsliding because his time spent with God became less and less and less until it was gone, because he got so progressive with the plumbing business. So that is why for me, the command is there, remember where you come from, where I started with you, and that do not forget that you have to be totally, because if we have all these blessings, we have the tendency. So I'm in not dependent of God anymore. Right. I have all these blessings. I can deal with anything. I have everything. So now remember where you come from. You need to be totally dependent of me. All these are coming from me. Totally submit to me. Right. So that's what I got. And I guess that will be answering the second command. Why remember, and for what purpose? And of course, as we remember, our faith gets stronger, you know, because we remember, oh, this is what God did for me. This is what I was before God. So, yeah. So, I mean, like, you value that, because sometimes all those blessings, we devalue already what God has done for us. And we think that I did this all by myself. I went to school for this. I went to college for this. And yeah, all my skills and ability because of all that. But we forget where that's coming from. And it's human nature. Yeah, but then we are not of that nature anymore. We have that supernatural nature, I guess. So, and that is my take.
Amen. So as Pastor said, like, remember, we're talking about remembering. She said that remembering is preparing us for the future. Sometimes that's why there are, like, if you don't remember, you forget things, right? That's what she said. And then remembering is making our faith more stronger. Why? It's not just the blessings that we remember. It's the journey that we go through, that we stumble, we fall. But God was there to hold us up. So it's not just the blessing, but it's also the pits and falls that we go through. And then the result is, like she said, like, it's preparing us for the future. It's strengthening us, strengthening in our faith. So those are the things that we put into, that's why remembrance is like the second command. I presume, I don't know if we all agree on that. Is what we are talking about now, remembrance. We have to remember what has transpired during our journey, our wilderness journey. So, you know, I just added that, though. Anybody else?
Are you going, Tita Percy?
Okay.
Okay. So for me, the second command also is in verse 2, that you shall remember. And I really believe that the Lord commanded the Israelites to remember him and to remember what he has done for them, so that their hearts may not harden towards him, but stay tender and humble through remembering. Mm-hmm. Because in remembering, you know, we become grateful, like what Pastora shared. And it's also when our hearts are tender and humble that we can look forward to what he has promised us and be able to believe him. And because in this chapter as well, the Israelites are still on their journey to the promised land. And I think in order for them to enter the promised land, you know, they must have a tender and a humble heart, because having a tender and a humble heart keeps us as well away from pride and unbelief. And I think, you know, he commanded them to not forget him, because God is preventing them from being prideful, that will result to hardness of heart and unbelief. And this is what happens when we forget what God has done. You know, it makes us familiar and even casual, that even the manna from heaven, you know, doesn't amaze them anymore, because they let their hearts become so used to it that they're so used to it, their hearts are not touched by it anymore. Their hearts are not touched by God's provision for them, and they started forgetting to be grateful to God. And because of that, mm-hmm. their hearts hardened towards him, and they became prideful, and they started following their own ways. And you know, pride is even the main root, like we all know this, of why Satan, despite of all the blessings and even the favor that was surrounding him in the throne room, you know, he forgot what the Lord has done and focused on the blessings that he could get, you know, the recognition, the fame and status that he could get. And it made him forget the Lord, and it hardened his heart and caused him to not believe in God as well. And even the older generation of the people that journeyed in the wilderness, all of them died because of unbelief and the hardness of heart. And the Lord allowed them to die in the wilderness and not enter the promised land because of the wicked condition of their hearts. And so what I really got here is that for us to be able to enter in our promised land, for us to keep on ascending in our relationship with God, we must keep our hearts tender. And I can only keep my heart tender when I position myself on remembering what God has done for me, and to not allow myself to be so familiar and to be so casual with the blessings that he has given me that I will forget to be grateful. Because like what Pastorish mentioned, that being grateful, that remembering is being grateful, and the password to his presence is thanksgiving and praise. And I think guarding our hearts as well is important, that even when God blesses with so much, you know, we must always remind ourselves that every good thing that we have is from him, and he has the power to take it back and to even bless us with so much more. So
amen. Anybody else? This is a prayer. I think you're opening.
No. Okay. So my answer, I'm just going to read it to you. Yung ano, my answer is, what is the first and the second? Mine is in verse 1 and verse 8. Sabi dito sa NIV. NIV said, be careful to follow every command I am giving you today, so that you may live and increase and may enter and possess the land the Lord promised an oath to your ancestor. And then on verse 11, sabi din niya, this is my answer. I don't know. Here. Sabi niya, be careful. Sabi niya sa verse 1, be careful to follow every command. And on verse 11, sabi niya, be careful that you do not forget the Lord your God. So basically, that's my question. But I'm going to go back. I'm going to go anyway. Everybody explained it already. I'm going to go on the remembering. Kasi sabi ng ganun dito, 'di ba? Why do we need to remember? I know Pastor Linda shared to us this about remembering is for us to prepare for the future, to prepare us for the big storm that is coming, to prepare us for the future without fear. And what do we need to remember on this? You know, I think one first thing that we need to remember is this: remember who our God is, right? Because as we know who our God is, that we know that our God is the creator, that is all-powerful, all-knowing, that he loves us so much, that will help us, you know, to be able to face the future. Another thing that is, because Because each and every one of us, we go through a lot of situation, a lot of storm that comes into our life, right? Just like me, I go through a lot of storm. The first storm that hits me is when I married my husband.
I concur.
That was a good storm.
Right? So we go through a lot of that. But I just want... And then another thing that we have to remember is we have to remember the past. Because the past will help us, you know, to be able to face the future with confidence, with hope, you know, that we know that there is God that loves us. You know, remembering those things that we go through in the past that, you know, how did we overcome it? When is the time that God intervened when I am in this position? You know, remembering all the answered prayer that the Lord answered, right? So another thing that we have to remember is remember the word of God. We know that the word of God is alive. The word of God is very powerful. As we remember all those verses, all of those words that God has given to us, it will help us and strengthen us, you know, to face the future without fear, to be strong. That will give us the courage and remembering the past will help us to be able to be strong for the future. Mm-hmm. And I just remember, just want to share to you, and I know I've always been sharing this because this really, this is the thing that I always remember when I go through a situation that the goodness of God is in my hand. Is when the big storm hit me, when I got the cancer. Before I go to that, on that day, I was about, my appointment to the doctor is about 10 o'clock. And Vert told me, he said, anyway, it's only, it's still early. CJ have a school at 8 and you didn't go to the school yet. You didn't meet the teacher. You didn't meet the kids. You didn't meet the parents. So why don't you go with me? And so you could see and meet the parents and the classmates. I said, yes, okay, let's go while we are, you know, trying to kill the time for 10 o'clock appointment to the doctor. So when we go there, I saw the kids. I saw CJ's classmate. One is in the wheelchair. One is wearing helmet. One is confused that he cannot control himself of what he's doing. One is, you know, you could see different things. And then when we go home, and I could see the parents are all stressful. You know, you could see that they're holding their children, they're taking care of their children. And then when we go home, I just cry because God put me in remembrance. Remember, I told you I will take care of you. You know, look, you know, this just, he just showed it to me that, did I tell you that I will help you to take care of CJ? You know, she grew up without much problem. She can walk, she can talk, she can, you know, it's just like the mind is the problem. And so when we were going home, I'm just crying because I remember that, you know, that they say I am still blessed, even though she is in that condition, but I'm blessed compared to the other parents. Now that's why when the doctor read the biopsy that she said that I have a cancer, I it's just like she just tell me, oh, you have an appendix. That's just like that, you know. It's not really that I cry or whatever, you know. Even the doctor, did you understand what I say? Because when she said, I'm sorry to tell you, but you have a breast cancer and it is, you know, malignant. And so I just said, oh, okay, doc, yes. I just say like that. That's why they said, did you understand what I said? I said, yes, yes. And then I even asked him, doc, can I go on vacation? And he said, no, you cannot go on vacation because we already have a plane ticket to go to the Philippines by December, and that was November. No, we need to do the treatment right away. But what I'm saying is, as you remember what the Lord did to you in the past, it will help you to face the next storm. And because of that, you know, if your personality, you become stronger and it changed you. I mean, it's really, I know when I go through the situation, it changed my personality. I become very patient. You know, I become, you know, my character changed.
Patient to me. Lead up to me.
What I'm saying is, that's why, you know, remembering, that's why every time Pastor Lindet shared the word, that the thing of remembering, it's really very meaningful to me, because I can attest to that. It happens to me for so many, many storms that I go through. And so that's why really it's very important for us to remember who our God is. Remember the past, how God helped us. Remember the word of God, because the word of God will help us. You know, okay, remember what he said, I will never leave you, I will never forsake you. So remembering is really, you know, very memorable to me. Amen. Praise God. Okay.
Amen.
I cannot add anything to that.
Yeah.
I think it's complete, Brother June.
That's right.
I'm sorry, I cannot put my camera because I'm using my cell phone. But anyway, I just give my take right now for like what everybody's saying for the first one and two and everything like that. So for me, it's just like really God called Israel to really complete obedience. And because of this, obedience was really the base on remembering what the Lord had done among them in the wilderness. And there are two things that I saw in this chapter, the chapter 8, when Moses mentioned to the Israelite that they had to really remember that the commandments in order that Israel might be received the blessing, which is already given for all of you guys. And also the second one is to really not forget, because like what Pastora said, that we have sometimes sickness of amnesia, you know, that we forget how the Lord gave us everything. And it is a warning that for not remembering the Lord. So for me, it is really important that we always have to remember what we came from and what we become now as Christian. Because every time I pray, not really every time, but I always thank God of his goodness, because he transformed me from where I am. I know that I wasn't a bad kid, or as growing up, I'm kind of obedient to my parents. But what I'm saying is, all of us are filthy in the sight of God. We were sinners, but because of that grace and mercy of God, he transformed us. And that is that I have must remember where I came from, because through those trials and testing, that's where we really cling to God, especially his word and everything, because all of us go through a testing, and that from those testings, you know, God is transforming us into the way that God wants us to be, you know, just like a potter that God mold us into that, from that pot up to that, into that pot that he wants us to be. And I believe that this is the focus of remembrance, is really for us to continue remember how God good in our lives is. It's not just focusing for all the blessing, but that's how also God wants us to know that from those blessings, that from those trials, he never forget his promises to us as his children. And he never forget that he never leave us nor forsake us. And because of that, we are still continuing to really focus on Jesus. Because for me, it's just like, yeah, there's a lot of trials, but also on the other side, with those trials, I became more stronger in facing more and more trials, you know, because sometimes mostly trials that we face in our life is not just only like sickness and disease and everything like that, but mostly the people around us. And sometimes, you know, you can be pulled down if you're not going to be strong. That's a lot of warfare. But what I'm saying is, it's just like for me, a lot of things, you know, that we have to thank for sa Panginoon, because it is our lives now, you know, that God is testing us in every way, especially in this last day. So that's my take for I think.
Amen.
So we have answered all three. Now we have to, maybe the young G has something to add. Anybody from the young generation?
For sure.
I can share. Yeah.
Fresh insight.
Oh.
Now you.
Go, Jeremy.
No. You keep going.
Okay, fine. I'll go first. I really want to go. The youngest of the YG. Right after Sister Percy's testimony, I was really encouraged to tell my testimony too, because this is what it is, right? We remember what God has done in our lives, and your testimony, Sister Percy, is very inspiring and very encouraging. So thank God for your testimony. But for us, for me personally, it's gonna be for the both of us, because I think for remembering is very important. Sister Percy already said it, but it just reminds me of, yes, we know that God is good, right? But when we remember what he has done in the past, it makes you more, you know, love him more and just adore him more for his goodness, for carrying us through, for healing Sister Percy. For us, it's his supernatural protection. And I don't know if you guys know, but you know, you guys know, you know, we have this house, we have jobs and all that stuff, but we did not like magically like have all these things that we had. We had to go through, you know, a process. You know, we, like Francis, we would always also, with remembering, we would remind our kids like, okay, you guys see our current situation, but we want to remind you what we had to go through in order for us to get to this, because you cannot just say, oh, I want to eat at so-and-so, but you know, we used to eat tinapa and tuyo, you know, when we were younger. I mean, when I was younger, we would eat pandesal with kape, right? And your rice would have sabaw of tubig, you know, like those things. My kids don't know that, right? Because, you know, they grew up here and they think that life is good, but it's not. And so we have to also remind them, you know, where we came from. And, you know, with even Francis, you know, we both came here when we were teenagers. So we didn't really like grow up here, kind of like, you know, with our YGs here. But, you know, when we came here, we had to work from the bottom and then work our way up. You know, we sent ourselves to school. We paid our tuition fees and all that from our own, you know, work salary, whatnot. But even Francis would remind the kids, like, I used to, you know, clean the toilet in the hotel. That was his job. And so don't think that, you know, when you get out of the college, you can have a $50 job when you get out of the college. Like, no, it doesn't work that way. You gotta. So we remind the kids that. But one of the things too, that we've experienced, that we really can say that God was really there. He never left us. He never forsook us. Is when we were at this one house, we used to live in Medan, and our neighbor were literally like drug dealers. And then every single night there would be like a raid, SWAT teams are there. And even one morning, Francis would just, you know, go out of our house and he would see what bullet holes in the fence. And it's so scary because hello, our kids were small, and I mean, and he works at night. I'm there during the day, and so it was scary. But I think that through that process, God, you know, how it's saying on our question, like the testing, God, with that testing, God, you know, purified us, help us through, and really we relied on God and depended on Him. That obviously not even the police can help us, right? Because up to that point, like, they can't arrest those people. And so it was all like supernatural, like protection of God, that he was just there for us. We were never hurt, and the neighbors were nice to us, but obviously, like, still, like, nice is not gonna help when, you know, things get worse, right? But it just reminded me that, yeah, God has been really good. He protected us. But, you know, also it was because of some wrong choices we made. He made. He did not include me in the decision making. I'm not trying to blame him, but I'm just saying. But, you know, like those things, you know, we learn from that. And so now, like, every time we make small moves, we consult one another, like, here's what I'm going to do here. You know, like, we learn from that experience. And so remembering it's very important. So that's what I wanted to share as far as my testimony, because Sister Percy, you were on point.
Amen.
Yeah, for me, remembering, I think for me, remembering is like, will keep you on track if you're still growing or not. So because, you know, if you remember things, you know, on your past, you will remember that you're back on what you came from. So the same as the Israelites, you know, where they were doing on circle. So they, you know, it's like remembering, it's like a measurement. Is it really, are you in track on growing on God's way, or you're on track going backsliding? You know, it's like a measurement. So if you remember things, how you've been before and how God is transform you, then you will know if you're on the right track or not. So for me, it's a parameter that I have to, it's like a checklist. Okay, I'm on the right track on growing, on maturing on God or not. That's cool.
Amen.
Jeremy, yeah. Goo.
Yes. Yeah, I just wanted to, like, really just agree with everybody's, like, sharing of remembrance and sharing your testimonies, and even me being still sort of young, not as old as
Okay.
But no, like, really, yesterday I was actually in the prayer center, and we were praying for somebody, and I was with, of course, people that were older than me, and he was somebody who was sharing that although we are older, we have so much, we are still like in the sense ahead of this young one, pointing at me to another brother. And he was saying, because of this, we have so much experience with God. We could look back all these past choices that we made, or experiences that we have, or situations that we've been put in, and we could see God really move in that. And but even for me, like, being still sort of young, still having personal experiences of how God really moved in my life, and how God really changed me from this person who had several issues, problems, and other things like that, and to now raising me up as his, and continue to work in me, raising me up as his child, as his disciple, and all of this. And I want to go back to what Patricia said, like, as we remember these things, always learning to not let it harden our hearts, not let it callous us, but to continuously give thanks to God, continuously be in gratitude for him, for what he has done. And of course, the most important one of all, like, him dying for our sins, dying for us, because of that, we're all saved, because we could believe in him, because we could trust in him, because we could have put our faith in him. And continuing to remember that, like, as it says in Pastor knows when she mentioned the Israelites and where they came from, and how he constantly had to remind them, this is where you were. You were in the lowest of low place and everything like this, mm-hmm. but I rescued you from this Egypt. I healed you of these things, and I'm taking to you to a better place. And although they had to go through like these trials and these places, like the end result is going to be so much better than we even realize right now. For us, that being heaven, and although we, for me, certainly I am still having to go through so much experiences, life, so many situations, so many things that even right now, I don't know if I'll be prepared for, but continuing to, as you guys said, for the future, drive that being our drive, remembering that God has been faithful throughout all your time in your life, and he will not stop, and he will Amen. Continue to be faithful, and he'll continue to show you just how good he is and just how much he loves mm-hmm. you.
Amen.
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 Okay.
I can Amen. Share. Yeah, so I think after the preaching and going back and listening, it made me actually reread one of my old journals. And I don't normally do journals, but after reading what I put, it stirred my heart to want to do it again, because I found an entry from June 23rd, 2015. And it talks exactly about that. It actually says, today I looked back at my past entries and I read all the stuff I put, and it reminded me of all the things God was doing in my life. It was crazy to remember how I was at these different times of my life, and to remember how strong I was in the faith. And I just kept going more and more. And it just reminded me that remembering, it's not just, okay, it'll prepare me for like the next thing, but it just stirs your heart. It just, the storyline of you and Jesus throughout your years, it just comes alive again. You know, it just brings you back to those moments, whether they were like really amazing, you know, gracious, like filled with blessing moments. But even in the dry seasons of your life, if you go back and you could actually like see it like through, especially with journals, right? And you could read how you were, and you put yourself back in time to what you were thinking, to how you were feeling about Jesus, about how your faith was. It just, these things just come alive again. And for me, it's encouraging. It makes me grateful, right? That's why Pastora said gratefulness is the door to wanting more, because it just does mm-hmm. something with your heart, and you're like, wow, God was there, right? This is mm-hmm. where I was at my life. You know, you could see the difference, right? I think someone talked about yes. that, right? You could see how much you've grown, or maybe not as grown, or maybe you would want to grow even more after realizing the difference. You could see just how he moved, and you could be like, wow, God, you were present. You were present at this moment. You were present in that moment. And whatever season you're in now, which is, I think the problem is there's something just happens in human nature where we tend to focus on the thing right in front of us. And it makes it so hard to remember the things behind unless we're intentional about it. So if we have like all these problems in our life, it's hard to remember like, oh yeah, God's been good. You know, like he's brought me through these things. It seems like these new problems are so much greater than what was happening before. But if we look back, we're like, wow, God was with me when I was lost. God was with me when I didn't even know him. You know, he was the one that came in and broke in and redeemed me from, you know, the clutches of sin and death. You know, like he brought me out of that. Like, what's this new problem? What can that possibly do against that kind of God, right? And if it's in the dry season, like God was in the dry seasons too. And if it's like something we're scared of or fearful of for the next step, right? I think Pastora talked about transitioning like just a few weeks ago about how sometimes we're hesitant to like move up to where God is bringing us to be, where we're hesitant to take that next step. But God was with us in the other transitioning periods before in our lives. And so I think it just reignites our faith, just remembering. Right. And Amen. Forgetting does the exact opposite of that. It kind of like diminishes who he is in us. It makes us dull in our connection with him. It kind of like separates it. It kind of distances it, like saying like, oh, those stuff never really happened. And so when we bring it to remembrance, you're like, no, this is who he is. Like, it's not just, and that's the difference, right? Of like someone that is so good at theology and just like looks at it as like the study material, and someone who just experiences mm-hmm. Jesus on the day to day. Because you look at theology books and then, yeah, it's not, you can just say those things, but when it happens in your life, you're like, no, I experienced it. Like, this is who God is. He really is a healer. He really is a miracle working God. He really is for me. He really did redeem me. And so I think it just expands our heart. It gets us ready, just like what my mom was saying, for the end time stuff that's happening. But even in just this moment right here, right now, and the craziness of the world and of life, it keeps us faithful. It keeps us grateful. It keeps us stirred and passionate to just live this life with him next to us, because he's never left. He's always been there. And if we go back, we can see it. Yeah.
Exactly. So remembering is very important, because, you know, we just don't, you say, as you said, there's dry season, there's bad season, there's good season. Remembering also, why do we have to go to trial? What are trials for? You know, so it works hand in hand in like, mm-hmm. what am I remembering? I know I went through trials. Did I pick up something from that? Or was it just like, let it go? And then you have, as Christians, we are so blessed that we learn from what to remember and learn from what we have gone through, especially our trials. Blessing is all fantastic and everything, but we grow in the love of God when we like understand that he was with us during those times. On the crossroad, what am I gonna do? And he will just, as we were talking about, he opens doors, he opens pathways for us, and that's what we remember. God, you was with us. And what's this trial coming? This is small. This is nothing compared to what God has brought me out from.
Mm-hmm.
So the question now I'm throwing is, why do we have testings? Man. What does it do to our character? So anybody, don't be excited. Just open, unmute yourself and start.
Okay. You know, the beauty of remembrance is we become more thankful to the Lord, you know, because of our experiences, right? But, you know, but we also experience testings, these trials. And sad to say, a lot of, even among Christians, a lot of them, either they grow more in the knowledge of the Lord or they go away from the Lord. And we you know, for us, we need to remember that. I would like to, like, you know, this thing that I read, you know, like how it was pictured, you know, it's perfect. It's like a painting, you know. Our life is just like a painting, you know. Like, you know, when the painter, when you start doing the painting, you don't see any beauty, you don't see anything, right? You know, until the last stroke becomes a masterpiece. And our life is pretty much like that. A lot of people start complaining, you know, because they focus on the now. They focus on their situation at the present. But they don't know what the plan of God is. And we know, as a believer, that the plan of God in our life is perfect. It's always good. It's just like the painter. You know, the finished product is always going to be good. And we will only find that out when our time is up. You know, how good the plan of God truly is. You know, but right now we are still, you know, in that process of being painted by the Lord. You know, we are still in that, hindi pa tayo yung finished product. We are not the finished product yet. And so, and the good thing about, you know, having that relationship, experiences with the Lord, is because it gives you more, you know, encouragement, you know, when, just like, you know, like what Percy and our experiences. Like, I remember Rendo, when Rendo was born, twice in my lap, you know, he had a seizure. And like, how many times, I cannot even count the number of times we keep on going back and forth in the hospital, you know,
mm-hmm.
for him. And that's why we were saying all the time, like, CJ is easy, Rendo is harder to, right? And Rendo is the most expensive child. Like, just comparing the hospital for the bills that was accumulated all those years. But you know, God is so faithful, and just
amen.
How he grew up in the knowledge of the Lord, and even right now, it's just, you know, how can you not remember? And so it just like just allows that, you know, and just seeing our kids now that like walking with the Lord, and all our experiences, like, you know, in our lives have never been like perfect or anything like that. You know, there's a lot of trials and tribulations and all these things also. Just like everybody else. But, you know, we always look up the Lord, and God never fails.
Amen. Yes.
Amen.
Amen. I think all of us, you know, goes to try. We have testing in life. It differs. Magkakaiba nga lang, you know. The testing that God gives all of us differs from one person to another. Sabi nga ni Pastor dito, testing is not to punish you, but to transform, to make your faith strong. And it is true. It is true that when God tests us, because he wants to know what is in our hearts, mm-hmm. as what he did to the Israelites. You know, he brought them to the wilderness because God wants to see what is in their hearts, if they will obey all his command or not, you know. And that is what God also wants us. You know, he gives us tests, yes. And I just praise God for all of his testimonies, you know, that we went through all of this. We went and we are still going through all of this. But it's different now that we are studying it. We know now, you know, how to deal with it, how to, you know, that God is the same. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. As what Pastor said in his last note, he said, remembering opens our eyes to see how faithful God is. Amen. He is faithful. You also sing that song, Great is Your Faithfulness. He is so grateful. He is so faithful to us. And his covenant to the forefathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Whatever his covenant to these three, our forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, it is also true to us. If Pastor also said there that the Israelites did not obey, you know, some did not obey, they did not obey. And somebody mentioned the young generation that went to the wilderness, they died on the way. And there were only two, you know, who saw the promised land. Moses saw, but he is on, you know, on the hill. But because of, you know, their murmuring and everything, God sees, God saw their heart. You know, they keep on murmuring. They keep on, God already, you know, that's why God brought them in the wilderness. And that is what we are undergoing now too. He is bringing out, we are, you know. But praise God, we know how to deal with it now, you know. And we stand in God's promises. Because that is the only one, like Sister Percy said, you know. We stand in God's word. That is our life. Mm-hmm. God's word is our life. And he said, it opens remembering it. It opens our eyes to how faithful God is, you know. All of us has experiences, you know, in the past. You know, mine is different from yours. My experience is, you know, as Sister Myra said, we came over here. But when I came here, I was already a professional. I left my teaching job in Manila to come over here. But when I came here, you know, when I left the Philippines, I said, I'm not gonna this anymore in America because they said there's a lot of jobs. And what I'm trying to say is, I also had difficulties in finances. That's the first thing that we had difficulties on. But I stood in God's promise. He said that I will supply, you know, I will supply. Because when I was in the Philippines, I was already a born-again Christian. And I tithe already. I keep on tithing, you know. That's why I always claim, Lord, I am doing everything, you know. I am not a perfect one, but I do. I give my tithes, you know. And God is really faithful. And then when I had my son, my buddy, you all know that his father died when he was only 2 years old. So he was left with me. And that is a big problem again. And I said, Lord, how can I raise my son now? And I am just an ordinary employee, you know. And then God showed me, led me to persons that will help me. And then so I had a social worker and, you know, she helped me. She said, this is what you're going to do because you are a low income mother, single, widowed. So she helped me. So Buddy, you know, had from elementary, going to high school, going to state college, and then going to university, I did not pay anything. It's all for free. That's why I am so thankful to God, you know. I said, God knows that I don't have any money. How can I bring my son? How can I educate my son? But praise the Lord that, you know, somebody helped me and gave me what my rights are as a citizen of America and as a single, you know, parent. Over here, if you are a single parent, they will help you. And if your child is really, you know, is really, really wants to go to school, they will help you. And that's what I did. And I just praise God. God is faithful if you are faithful, you know. That's why we are studying remembering. Yes, I remember where I have came from. And I remember what I am now. And I know you know, my remembrance is what I'm going to go, what is my future? And that is, you know, to be with God. And that is the only way. For me, that is the only way, you know. And I just praise God. I hear everybody of you. We are all the same. And I just praise God now that we are studying this. We know now how to deal, you know, with all of these problems, as Pastor said, and Sister Percy also mentioned. Why are we looking at this message today as forerunners? And I just want to read because we want to remember how God has saved us. We want to, and continuing to save us, for us to see his care and faithfulness all this time, see? So we may be led to triumph in our future. Gratefulness is our door for more, see? Let us not forget to be grateful. Whatever comes our way, thank you, Lord. I always thank you, Lord, because everything, the word of God says, you know, everything that happens to us has a purpose. And that is what I always ask, Lord, what is your purpose? Why you gave this to me? And that's how I learn. And that is how, you know, all of us, praise the Lord, now that we are sharing our testimonies, you know, we are all the same. We passed through all of this and we are still passing through all of this, but it's different now because we know that the God that we are serving is alive and he is always there. Sabi nga, it is only a prayer away, you know, God is only a prayer away. And praise God for our son, our tonight, remembrance.
Amen, amen.
Amen,
amen.
That's
I just want to add it in. Oh, yeah. Sorry.
No, sige. Go ahead.
Actually, I just want to add it in what Nona is saying about the testing and everything, that it is really transformed us to make us strong. Like what Pastora said, that it is a result in less dependence in ourselves, more dependence on God and his promises. And it give and it grows our faith. Because mm-hmm. in those testing, you know, I remember when I came also here in America, my sister is just like trying to win me to go to Iglesia Ni Cristo, you know. And I was already born again when I came here. And it, there was a point that she told us to look for another place, you know. And that time I don't have a job. I was only like three weeks in United States of in here in the US. And we almost slept, me and my husband, in the car, having all our blankets, our clothes in the car, you know. That was like tough. But then God is so good. And there was a point also that, you know, there was like, we almost lost our house because, you know, both of us lost our job. And there was a point that I told JJ and Mariel that, you know, we have to tighten our belts or whatever, the food in the table, that's what we have to eat, right? So, but God is so good because he is really a provider. You know, I remember that when I lost my job, you know, at the VA, God is using people to use so that there's to get the resources, you know. And then there was like a time that I was worried also, of course, when you lost a job, both of you doesn't have money or you don't have a job, you know, you kind of worry, you know, that we're gonna lose our house, you know, where we cannot pay anymore the mortgage and everything like that. But God is so good because at that time there was like Obama, like a program. And when you go to this program, I went to this program that if you don't refinance your house, you know, or sell your house after 3 years, you don't need to pay that money that the government help you. And that was like a year, you know, that the government helped us to pay our monthly mortgage. And that was a lot of relief, you know. And that time we did be able to save also. And I mean, I'm not saying that this all the blessing, but it is remembering how God save us from our wilderness, because all of us has, you know, a wilderness in our lives, whether in sickness or a lot of testing, you know. But God is always so, so good, you know, that makes us stronger, increasing our faith every day in our life.
Amen.
I mean.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So, go ahead. Who's talking? Who's gonna speak?
I'll share something.
Okay.
Yeah. Because when it comes to a lot of testing and trials, from my experiences, you know, I've grown to really understand that it is through this, that like it's a process where God allows me to, like, he uses those experiences to perfect my love and my trust for him. You know, I've grown to realize that, you know, and a lot of the trials and the situations that I've been, I always have this thinking where it's like, God, I feel like I can't handle this. You know, I feel like this is way too much for me. And then there comes in this remembrance and God tells me, yes, of course it's going to be too much for you because you're doing it on your own, you know? And, you know, it is in those situations where, you know, I get flooded with reminders of just how important it is to abide in God, how important it is to trust in God. And, you know, once I start to make that decision and step to really put my faith and trust in him, that's when I get to see how I overcome, you know, my situations and trials. And, you know, I get this thinking and this realization, like, wow, God, like, you are so good and you are so kind. But for some reason in my faith and in my life, you know, whenever I see another trial situation, I always go back to always telling God, like, God, why? This is too much for me. This is this and that. Right. And so I feel like for me, God has really been refining me as we talked about, to really not to go back to that initial type of thinking to, you know, oh God, like this is too much, but to really make that first step and first decision to really put my faith and trust in him. Because, you know, I always tell myself this, and I always remind myself this, you know, if God has been faithful to you during this moment in your life, you know, he can do it again in whatever situation you're in. And that's something that I've always been holding on to in whatever sort of trial, whatever sort of tribulation that I face with. And, you know, the more that I experience these things, you know, the thing that Pastora really that in her preaching that really struck my heart is, you know, we shouldn't be afraid of trials, you know, and I think that's something that I really need to grasp still in my life, to really embrace these trials and situations, because, you know, it is through those things that God is able to refine my love, refine my faith toward him, right? Because for me personally in my life, you know, I always have that feeling of, oh, like God, like, you know, I don't like, in all honesty, like, I don't like the feeling of being tested. I don't like the feeling of being tried, because, you know, like, it's not a good feeling, right? But of course, like, once we enter into that process and once we exit out of it, and what we've been always talking about, you know, when we remember like all the trials and all the tribulations that we've overcome, you know, we start to realize like, wow, God, like, you have been so good. You know, I want to continue to ascend. I want to continue to grow, right? And so that's why I really want to be able to shift my mindset to really enjoy, you know, trials, to really enjoy, you know, these refining sessions, because I know that it is through these sessions, you know, as long as I abide by him, you know, I will come out stronger than I was before, you know. And I know that sometimes for me, like, when I look at myself, like right now, I'm like, wow, like, I'm not God, like, I feel like I'm not really growing as much as I want to. But when I really take a step back and see like how much, like, how I've been, you know, just say like a year or 2 years ago, you know, that's when God really gets to show me his perspective as to like how much I've grown personally, not just me, but as us, even us as a church, you know, as a body. And so that's why it's so important for me to always remember, to always be reminded of how God has been, how God has been working in each and every one of our lives. Because, you know, it continues to encourage me, continues to like increase in my love and my devotion for God. And so that's just something that's always been something that I've always been that's always been a part of my life that I continue want to really take a hold of. Yeah.
Amen.
I was listening to Angelo, and I remember what the video I was listening. The testing, the fire, the heat, when we purify gold. So, okay, we're okay. Let's deal with the fire, with the heat, the extreme heat now. That it just dawned on me, if I don't do this, what about dealing with the fire of hell at the end? Right now, so how are we gonna deal with the fire of hell? I mean, like, so might as well deal with our fire right now. it's just like testing, why testing? And it just reminds me of the goodness of God with the testing and trial. Why? Amen. Because God loves us so much that right now he's equipping us for a bigger battle. Mm-hmm. And so he doesn't want anyone to perish. That's so right. If we can deal with these trials today, how are we going to deal with the bigger battle if we don't equip ourselves? So, and the same manner, if we're not going to deal with the heat today, how are we going to deal with the heat of hell? So that was just when Angela was talking and it just reminded me of the heat.
That's right.
The extreme fire.
It's 24/7 fire.
Yeah.
There's no excuse. There's no timeout for that.
You cannot put it out.
Anyway, anybody else before
Amen.
We? So yeah, that would be. Just imagine when we face Jesus one and one. There's different narrative of our life. You know, they're like trials that we go through. They're blessings that we go through. And when we like remember those things, we will remember what God has done for us. You know, he never just let it go. I remember my sister said, God will not give you a trial that you cannot handle.
That's
and right. He's always there. He's always there to really like hold you, you know, walk, There's the remember that the was that walking in the sand? Was that mom?
Footprints in the sand.
And yeah,
footprints in the sand. Only two footprints because God's carrying you all the time. So it's a good analogy for that. And just imagine we face him face to face, and we'll tell him the story that we have, how he goodness of God. So before we close, I'll just leave you with this verse. It's in Lamentation. I was just looking at it. It says Lamentation 3:22-23. This is a famous verse. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness.
Amen.
So that is a very, you know, that's will we have to hang on. Every morning when we sleep with a problem, next day there's God will be there. He's gonna, amen, you know, clean up that problem for us. As long as we continue to abide, trust, believe, put our faith in Him. So anybody else before we close, I'd ask Brother Ver to close us in prayer.
Okay, Brother Ver, you'll close us in prayer, okay? But before that, ito lang yung, I just want to share yung isa sa scripture na binigyan ni Pastora last Sunday, Psalm 66, verse 12. Mm-hmm. You have allowed our enemies to prevail against us. We have passed through fire and flood, yet in the end, you always brings us out better than we were before, saturated with your goodness.
Amen. So,
and definitely, as a believer of Jesus Christ, like what you said, Brother June, in the beginning when you started the Bible study, after we accepted Jesus Christ, we are there in the wilderness because trials, that is part of us being Christian, to experience these trials and testing. It is because that is where we're going to be purified, we're going to be increasing our faith. And that's one thing, one scripture that, you know, touched my heart when Pastora gave the message last Sunday. Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Let's pray. Hallelujah. Heavenly Amen. Father, we thank you and we praise you for tonight. Thank you, Lord, for this this Bible study, Lord.
Yes.
You have given us tonight. Lord, thank you for that topic of remembrance, Lord. Remembering the things that we have experienced for you. Thank you, Lord, for remembering, Lord, your promises to us and who we are in you. And we thank you, Lord, that we can remember all these wonderful things that you have done in our life in the past, that even though we go through situations in life, just like everybody else, Lord, we have that assurance of your promises that you will never leave us nor forsake us, and that we can always cling to you, that we can always cling to your words, for your words are all yes and amen.
Yes.
So Father, thank you for my brothers and sisters you have gathered tonight. Thank you, Lord, for the message, and thank you, Lord, for what you are doing to each one of us, that day by day, Lord God, you are transforming each one of us, your image and likeness. And I pray, Lord God, that we will continue to walk in your ways, that when our time is up, Lord God, that you will find each one of us faithful to the very end. So thank you, Lord God, once again for tonight, as we entrust our life unto you. Thank you for Brother June for facilitating, Lord God, this Bible study, as he remains faithful unto you, Lord God. Continue to give him the desires of his heart and continue to bless him and his family as well. And Lord, we just entrust everything unto you. We love you, we praise you. This we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.